Hello again, folks. It's Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. And today is kind of a special treat. This is a Telex TMS1001 12 cartridge changer. It'll hold 12 8-Track tapes, and it'll play them one right after the other. And we're just giving them a quick test here. A few things I'll mention is Telex, there are a couple of different models put out by Telex on the 12 cartridge changers. The first one was actually designed by Quatron, which Telex bought out later. This appears to be Telex's own design, based upon the general styling, the era of the electronics inside, and other factors. Basically, they took this machine, bought it from Quatron, and said, you know what, we can put out a machine that does the same thing with a lot cheaper. And so that's what they did. You can see this doesn't have nearly as many buttons as the Telex that I demonstrated on my last video. And there is a trade-off in quality, for sure. One thing that I didn't really care too much for about this model of the Telex is that there's no timing shapers. The reject button is also the track change button for manual track change. And depending how long it's held down, as well as how long the actual length of the foil splices on the tape, can sometimes affect its track changing behavior. And so that's one thing I didn't like about it. It does occasionally skip a track. It occasionally repeats a track. There's just nothing that can be done about that. It's nothing but micro switches in there that are adjusted, and they're doing what they're supposed to do. So it's just some cost cutting measures that they did. It was around 75 that this came out, and it was pretty well known at that time that the 8-track was being phased out by the cassette. So anyway, let's go ahead and turn her on and just make sure everything works. Got some Bobby Vinton here, and I'm just going to go through just a quick explanation. This top button here is labeled A1 and A4. In the top position, it'll switch cartridges after the fourth track is completed playing. Press down A4, you can play the same tape all day long, and it'll never switch. So that's the only difference with this switch here. This is just a stereo mono switch. This would, you know, just normally be kept in the stereo position. There's no reason to really have a mono stereo switch. So let's go ahead and turn it back up and make sure that it changes tapes and all that cool stuff. Don't be fooled. Okay, we're switching tapes. That was track 4. It's time I think of you. Now it's going to switch, just like that. And at any time, you can change cartridges in the carousel. It'll just keep playing those tapes in succession. Okay, now we're going to switch tapes. Okay, I must have missed it that time. A little bit jumbled and jumbled. A real life girl. Or is it because I've got the switch? My love, I'd be let's hope that was just a random glitch. First time that it's happened. Yeah, that was just a little hang up. Okay, and that's pretty much it. All right, there we are. So we'll just turn her off. And I would not advise keeping a cartridge in this position because it keeps it pressed down against the capstan, and it could it'll eventually put a dent in the tapes roller. So anyway, she's been put through the paces, and as you can see, she occasionally skips a track, occasionally repeats a track. It's just kind of a clunky design. They didn't keep those timing circuits in there, those timing shapers, and that's got a little bit to do with the false changing and the non-changing. And it could also be because I've been doing the whole thing manually. It's probably a lot more uniform with the automatic. So anyway, on that happy note, we're going to get out of here. She's ready to go back to the customer. And I'm Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. Needless to say, if you have an 8-Track either for home or for car use and need of service, you can reach me at 928-533-9666. I also do FM conversions on classic car AM radios. I can add Bluetooth, USB reader, more station presets, more output power, and who knows what else. My website is in the description below. Thank you very much for watching and listening, and we'll see you next time.